All right, Greg in Real Life coming at you here with a new little thing we're going to start doing. We're going to be playing WWE 2K16. We're going to be doing the Hall of Fame Showcase. I'm actually really excited to play this. I believe there's 7 matches, I believe, on this. I'm excited. Let's hop into it. Right here you can see we got Macho Man there. I think that might be the first match. I don't know, but let's see. Difficulty's going to be normal, everything. I'll do half on that. We'll just, fuck it. Who cares? Let's just do it. I'm excited. Hall of Fame. This is, I did 100% on Austin. But here we go. Hall of Fame Showcase. Let's go.
This year, we celebrate the WWE Hall of Fame class of 2015.
350 pounds of rough shaking.
Kevin Nash is just too weak.
All have earned their place in history, but one Hall of Famer personified the meaning of being one of the most recognized and passionate performers.
Oh yeah.
In WWE history.
Oh yeah.
The Macho Man Randy Savage, one of the all-time greats, ladies and gentlemen.
From his show-stealing performances as Intercontinental Champion to his remarkable reign as WWE World Champion, Macho Man Randy Savage made his mark in sports entertainment like no one else before.
And I think that the spotlight should go on top because I am Macho Man Randy Savage.
And with the First Lady of WWE, Miss Elizabeth, by his side, the charming couple captured the hearts of the WWE Universe worldwide. Entering a career-versus-career match at WrestleMania 7, Savage adopted a new attitude, which caused the couple to grow apart. Despite the circumstances, Miss Elizabeth's devotion to the Macho Man remained. And even though Savage's in-ring career ended that night, the Macho Man still came out a winner in the end.
She loves him! She's loved him from the beginning!
In true Macho Man fashion, he came out a true winner. After the dramatic scenes of WrestleMania, the WWE Universe waited with bated breath in anticipation of the big question.
Elizabeth, will you marry me?
Oh, yeah!
And under the lights, in a match made in heaven, their storybook wedding was sealed with a kiss. But what seemed like a fairy tale ending soon turned into a nightmare. The dastardly actions of Jake the Snake Roberts would emotionally scar Elizabeth. The cold and calculated mind games began to take its toll on the Macho Man. He was forced to helplessly watch from commentary as the snake spewed his venom.
Here's a man that used to be a real man, but obviously he's grown a little soft hiding behind the skirt of a woman.
Savage could not sit idly by and would confront Jake the Snake Roberts to defend the honor of his wife.
Down goes Randy Savage!
Get out of there, Macho!
Oh, I remember this Cobra bite right here.
The snake is gnawing on the arm! Jake Roberts
really bit him, too. I guess they were freaking out about that.
After careful consultation with the Macho Man, Randy Savage, and his doctor, it is my decision that he be reinstated immediately, and that a match between Randy Savage and Jake Roberts be sanctioned, which will be this coming Tuesday night in Texas.
The stage was set. No snakes, no more mind games. Randy Savage and Jake Roberts would settle the score at this Tuesday in Texas.
It's Tuesday in Texas is the event, I guess we're playing this at. Pretty excited.
Deep in the heart of Texas, it's going to be Jake the Snake Roberts and Macho Man Randy Savage.
I'm looking forward to it. Wait a minute.
What? From behind.
There's a man attacking him.
Jake Roberts just got introduced to the ring post.
And Randy Savage in a hurry to get this one started, JR.
Savage. Roberts, no love lost.
Looking like a fucking peacock.
And they both can be very, very dangerous. Both are inherently very evil, quite frankly.
I'm going to tell you something. Randy Savage is taking it to, ooh, Jake the Snake. Look at those left hands.
And look at that Pepper Snake.
Man, I miss old Randy Savage.
The Pepper Snake with those left jabs and a rake of the eyes. Savage throwing the rule book right out the window here in Texas.
I'll tell you, Jake the Snake, he didn't know what hit him. Randy Savage on it from behind, and it's been all Savage so far. Look at this. Oh.
Irish whip, reverse elbow. Down goes Jake the Snake Robert, who was in big-time trouble here. Randy Savage looking to, end this Murder King.
Oh, boy.
High risk. One up top. Macho Man.
Oh, look out. Ooh.
Can you dig it? Well, Macho Man with a double sledge on Jake the Snake Roberts.
Here comes Macho to deal out some more pain.
Another sledge in the back of the head. And a straight right hand. Big right
this
hand.
This is a pretty long
Macho
intro.
Man, Randy Savage. And Jake can't get far enough away from the Macho Man.
Here we go. Hey, Savage. Oh, yes, I am.
What a vendetta we have here. This is for all the marbles. And for Randy Savage, this is for retribution.
Oh, yeah.
This is for his lovely wife, Elizabeth.
Love this old feel, though, of old WWF.
About that 14-foot King Cobra gnawing on his arm.
To your point, King, you can see that Savage's arm, his left arm, by the way, is heavily bandaged. You'd have to think that Roberts sees that as a target.
Very 90s outfit right now by Macho Man, though. Look at this. This is very, very loud. Whoa. There's no announce table. Oh, yeah. That's when they used to do it back, like, near the stage. McMahon. Just going to damage
Randy
Mr.
Savage making his statement
Jake Roberts by the, ringside here.
The ring is survival. The match becomes almost secondary.
Oh, gut wrench. Bow. Bow down. Subjects. Man, Jake the Snake and, like, Jake Roberts and just even Macho Man back then.
Oh, the velocity.
This is really special match, man.
You could hear it.
It's going to be hard to rebound from that one.
Five.
Really? Oh, in the ring.
Protect the neck.
Not, like, into the ring. Ha. Let's get this man up.
All they got here, JR.
Here we go. Gotta be quick with this guy. Gotta pick the right one.
Savage reverses. And, referee dodged the bullet there.
You're not kidding. Ooh, look at that knee.
Jake Roberts got the knee right in the face of the Macho Man, Randy Savage. Can you dig it? Ooh, yeah.
All they got here. Jake Roberts trying to get control of this thing. Wow.
A roundhouse.
Sometimes I don't watch the animations. I'm just focused on what button to push for the QTE.
Yeah, but don't waste any time on the Macho Man. And Jake Roberts losing valuable time after gaining the advantage. Is he signaling for the DDT?
Yeah, I'm afraid he is. This is going to be bad for the Macho Man.
One DDT and it's over.
Ooh, yeah.
Savage trying to fight his way back up. Showing a lot of guts and courage. And there it is, front face lock in.
Oh, this is going to be bad for my... Whoa!
Bam! What impact. That may have busted some ribs there.
Oh, no kidding. Macho Man saved himself.
All right, I guess
he's
got to
be simply reminding him that he's there. Being shown here.
No, not again.
Mr. Roberts is a freaking technical genius over here, reversing everything.
Roberts with the reversal.
Fuck you up, Jake.
Oh, what impact!
Yeah, man. I miss these two guys. Actually, I wish.
And his attack.
I hate that, like. You know,
he wants this
when I got into wrestling, Jake Roberts wasn't actually really wrestling that much anymore.
Do another gear here
and
tonight.
Then Macho Man was in WCW, and we all know how WCW really was. I mean, actually, he was doing pretty good in WCW, but, like, I just know that, like, his WWE stuff or WWF stuff was so much better than his WCW run was.
Oh, this is going to be good.
We're going one big for the big elbow drop. And oh my god. What a reversal by Mr. Jake the Snake. Jesus Christ, man.
It's nearly impossible to deal with this type of power.
But yeah, I was always a fan of Savage, though, even as like a little kid. I remember he was like one of my very first WCW action figures.
No problem getting out of that one. No, not again.
Even Hogan, too, at the time, like, I didn't even get to really experience the mega powers. I just noticed, knew them from WCW, and that's how I grew up with them, basically.
The shoulders are down.
Mind you, I wasn't a fan of wrestling until about 96.
Oh, wait, nice reversal. He's pulling out all the stuff.
So, you know,
tonight,
like, my first memories of Hulk Hogan was him being, you know, really cool and everything, and then like him turning on all
he's
the fans and
trouble.
Calling them
ooh, the head just
garbage
there.
And stuff like that. So it's very strange. Getting a little gas there, Savage. Power drive your ass again. Break your neck, son. What's Savage gonna do here?
Attacking from the top. Here we go.
I love this finisher, and I think he just reversed it again.
Oh, that's gonna put
there we go.
And look at this.
Awesome.
And Macho Man has won this match with only one arm, JR.
Yeah, that Cobra bit Savage in the arm, and Savage still came back and won the match with one arm.
Absolutely amazing.
One-on-one matchup.
Well, you're right about that. What a battle. But there you see it. Macho Man, victorious.
Randy Macho Man Savage, if you can dig it, he can dig it. But there's a man that got it done. Jake the Snake Roberts says, Savage.
Hey, wait a minute. Look at this.
What's going on here?
I think Savage wants a little more of Jake the Snake.
Savage got the ring bell.
Oh, no.
The time I don't use the ring bell anymore. I noticed that.
It's a dangerous weapon. Get that bell ramp.
Oh.
DDT.
Oh, my
a
God.
Thunderous DDT by Jake the Snake Roberts, who has lost this match fair and square to Randy Savage. But Jake Roberts retaliating with an illegal DDT because it came after.
Every time I see Jake Roberts do the DDT, he just looks devastated.
But I'm going to win this war.
Keep going. Well, certainly the snake, Jake the Snake, that is, has left the Macho Man with something to think about. This rivalry game is far from over, quite frankly.
Yeah, you can tell by the look on the face of Jake the Snake Roberts. This is not over.
He's a psychotic human being.
Oh, no, 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 no.
A sadist, lust and inflict pain, mind games, physical games.
You got another snake here, buddy? Beat your way, yes.
This is WWE, you idiot.
Oh, my gosh.
Where in the hell's Marlon Perkins when he needs it?
He's got that damn snake. Oh, no, this
there's no reason for this. Miss Elizabeth.
Miss Elizabeth.
Go in there.
Miss Elizabeth trying to come to the aid of Macho Man Randy Savage.
Miss Elizabeth, don't put yourself in harm's way.
Come on, Jake, brother. Come on,
Jake. Jake escaped with Savage again. What's he going to do here?
Look at him. Look right at Elizabeth. What a cruel human being.
Oh, what a DDT.
What a cruel human being. Another DDT. Good grief. Enough is enough.
Yeah, Jake the Snake Roberts has definitely gone over the edge here.
Find him. Cost him some money.
Get him out of here.
Get him out of here is right. Send him back to the psych ward.
You're lucky, Roberts. I'll get up and beat your ass.
A woman in jeopardy, and Jake Roberts can't figure out what he's done wrong.
Worst case of a sore loser I've ever seen. Get him out of here.
Yeah, find him. It's finding. What the hell?
You know, the Macho Man, he... But he didn't win the war.
Another member of the WWE Hall of Fame class of 2015 is Rikishi. The 400-pound Samoan captured the hearts of the WWE Universe with his bleach blonde hair, sunglasses, and unmatched dance moves.
That Rikishi is fat, all right? P-H-A-T.
The charismatic big man used his size and unique moveset to disarm his opponents.
No, no, not this!
Rikishi made his mark in an era that was defined by attitude, and no man represented that more than Stone Cold Steve Austin.
I did it for The Rock.
But at the 1999 Survivor Series, during the peak of his popularity, Austin was targeted by an unknown assailant.
For God's sakes, the car just ran over Austin!
The brutal attack would put Austin out of action for nearly a year with a neck injury. During his absence, Commissioner Mick Foley conducted his own investigation and finally came to a shocking conclusion.
I did it.
What?
I did it for The Rock. We were always held back. And I'm talking about High Chief Peter Maivia, Alpha and Sika. They were all held back.
Misguided, Rikishi's admiration for The Rock soon turned to rage as the Great One refused to support Rikishi's actions.
The Rock wants nothing to do with you. So Rikishi, stay out of The Rock's life.
What are you doing, Rikishi? What's wrong with you?
I thought The Rock was like family to Rikishi.
The Rock's gotta do what The Rock's gotta do, whether you like it or not.
Oh, look at
the two were on a collision course towards Survivor Series.
My God, don't do it!
Rikishi, holy shit.
Rikishi, just drop The Rock!
See you at Survivor Series with your punk ass.
Fuck.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, weighing 424 pounds, Rikishi!
Rikishi, the man that ran over Stone Cold 1 year ago, right here at the Survivor Series in a plan well orchestrated by The Game.
And speaking of The Game, he and Austin will get it on later on tonight. And much like this one, it's going to be incredibly personal.
Rikishi. I did it for The Rock. The Rock, I did it for you, brother. If you smell. Well, here he comes, the Great One.
If you smell, The Rock is coming.
Sprinting to
him. Look, there's the Great One. The Rock and Rikishi one-on-one. And man, this damn thing is personal, King, I can tell you that.
You're right about that, Rock. He's like a wounded animal right now. He wants to end this thing early.
And Rikishi, oh my God, what elevation.
Man,
oh
man.
Oh, The Rock. Great elevation on a mere 400-pound Rikishi. And now the Great One is looking for something.
Hey, wait a minute, Rock. Not that chair, you'll get disqualified. Wait a minute, look out. Oh.
Referee unarms The Rock with that steel chair, and this match will continue one-on-one.
Oh, no!
Oh, Rikishi with a straight super kick that caught Rock right in the face, it looked like.
I'm going to tell you, this is exactly opposite of what Rock
time to beat
for.
The Rock.
It was just last Monday night when
The Rock.
That black car with Rikishi hanging out the window. Rikishi then proceeded to hit The Rock right in the sternum.
Damage, Rikishi. Oh, yeah.
I actually think that Triple H would have run The Rock over if he'd had the chance.
You might be right, King, but the point remains. I don't think The Rock is 100% tonight. Maybe this is.
Look at that float over DDT. Pow.
That was a ton of velocity. He's showing everyone what he's got.
Yeah, sorry if I sound a little weird too. I'm also getting over a cold.
He's got him.
So you might hear me sniffle a lot and just
not your garden all that variety good stuff. Impact on that one. Pushing
just getting over a cold. I feel like, were they trying to give Rikishi a push at this time? So I don't think anything came out of it. That I remember at least.
Two. Just making his presence felt there.
Oh yeah. The Rock's move, aka the Samoa Drop.
Open in this game, folks.
When he gets going like this, there are few better.
Oh no. Kishi getting pissed.
Kishi's showing his skills.
Gotta watch out for the Hall of Famer.
Stopped him dead in his tracks.
I was always the kind of he's kind of like Rikishi.
Oh my gosh, look at this.
Uh-oh. Outside, I don't like it out here. What's my God! The referee just got wiped out.
Remember when he did that big splash off top of the cage? It's one that always kind of sticks to me. That was crazy.
Well, we don't need a match with the
oh yeah, and then again,
without an
freaking choke slam off the Hell in the Cell.
Wait a minute. Look at Rikishi. What's he got?
What are you doing, Rikishi?
Well, oh no!
Sledgehammer!
Not Triple H, it's his gimmick infringement.
That sledgehammer! My God almighty, can you only imagine the damage that can be done with a sledgehammer?
Oh my gosh, come on, Rikishi, don't do this.
Come on, Rikishi, you know better than this.
We need some help out here. This is not gonna be good. Don't turn around, Rock.
The Rock can barely stand.
You're not gonna like the view.
Got it.
He's swinging for the
oh yeah.
All the Rock with the right hand.
Lay if the smack if down.
That'll Rikishi.
Oh no.
The Rock bottom, the Rock bottom. How do you rock bottom a 420 pounder just like that?
Only the Rock.
It's called working out, JR. Holy shnikes. Got frickin' reverse there, you see that?
Right on the shoulder. You know that bone in there, the clavicle, is extremely easy to break.
Get off me, bitch. Now you done pissed me off.
An atomic drop! That'll buckle your knees!
Okay, let's miss the clothesline there, Rocky. Pick up his fat carcass. I'm fat too, I can't talk shit.
Reversal! Rikishi showing his skills!
God damn it, Rikishi, you're pissing me off!
Nice!
Take that, big boy.
He's targeting the midsection.
Damn, he threw me.
In time.
Oh, fuck. Give me a headbutt again, punk. God damn, Rikishi. Fuck you.
How in the world did he counter that?
Oh my God, really? That's actually quite annoying. Fuck you.
He lands the strike.
You gotta be fucking kidding me, dude.
He's in big trouble.
I take back everything good I ever said about him.
If he keeps up this pace, this could turn real ugly, real fast.
Tremendous reversal.
Well, it might be smart for the ref to call for the bell. That neck looks to be in bad shape. Uh-oh, look at this!
Pull the off center. That's all right. Fuck you.
That's it. He's out.
Here. Now the Rock's getting with his
feet. Yeah, bitch.
Yes! The Rock wins it. Man, what a battle. What a battle. The Rock is spent after that war with the
Here is your winner.
Oh, man, JR. This is unbelievable. What a win for the Rock.
How did the Rock do it? How did he survive this 420-pound man? And the Rock is having a hard time regaining his equilibrium.
Well, you're right about that. I'm afraid just from looking at the Rock, he may never be the same after this.
Rock could have some internal damage here. I don't want to speculate.
Hey, wait a minute.
Oh, the super kick. Right to the face from the 420-pounder.
Wait a minute. I thought this match was over.
This match is over.
Come on.
Hey, ref, the match is over.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God. Not this. Not the... No, come on. Oh, my. The bonsai drop. Get off.
Fuck you, Rikishi.
A whole lot of ass fall right on the chest.
420 pounds worth. Not again. Oh.
Good grief. Ref stuck in there. Pull the Rock out of harm's way.
Yeah, we got to get some help.
Fuck me up.
Sense of urgency, fellas. There's two bonsai drops.
Wait. He's going up again, JR. Hey,
the Rock's going to be...
Oh.
The Rock's career's in jeopardy here thanks to Rikishi. What the hell is wrong with Rikishi?
Oh, he's lost it.
That's a fun, goddammit.
Come on. Get the security out here.
Rikishi snapped, JR.
Bonsai drops. Now the referees are being assaulted. And the Rock has, by the way, if you're keeping score at home, the Rock has won the match.
Yeah, but not the war.
Now what?
That's three bonsai drops.
What do you want now, Rikishi? What is it you haven't done?
No. Not another one.
What kind of human being is Rikishi?
Oh,
my goodness.
Get
out of here. That's enough. That is absolutely enough.
Then they got to bring back beating up the referees. They don't do that enough. Makes for good entertainment.
Would you please welcome Alundra Blaze?
I think I'm going to do this match and I'm going to split the videos. And then I'll do the last other ones in the part two.
What a competitor, what an athlete.
WWE Hall of Famer Alundra Blaze was arguably the most dominant female wrestler.
I had a crush on her when she was Medusa.
And one of the greatest talents in sports entertainment history.
Obviously, she is afraid of no one. Wants to take on all comers. The new Women's Champion. Congratulations, Alundra Blaze.
Blaze captured the WWE Women's Championship an impressive three times.
Alundra Blaze, once again, the Women's Champion.
With such an incredible resume, it'd be hard to imagine any diva being better than that.
You know what? I am better than that.
Paige was not only the first ever NXT Women's Champion, but also
she's my favorite diva, by the way, Paige.
Divas champion, with an outstanding list of achievements at a remarkably young age, Paige is at the forefront of the Divas Revolution and shows no signs of slowing down anytime soon.
I'll challenge you right here and now.
It's the two most dominant divas of their generations.
That is my championship, and this is my house.
Little side note on Paige. I wish Paige would just go back to being the anti-diva.
WrestleMania.
Just don't give her a real good run. She was phenomenal in NXT, I thought. This is an interesting little match we have here, though.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Norwich, England, Paige.
Since her debut the night after WrestleMania 30, Paige has cemented herself as one of the most dominant divas in all of WWE.
Oh, dominant indeed. But Paige isn't your average diva, JR. She refuses to be a cookie-cutter diva. Paige insists on blazing her own trail.
Oh, Paige. Her motto doesn't look that good in this game, but boy, she's a babe. Look at, oh god. About to fuck up Alundra Blaze, though. Wow.
Her opponent from
old school
Florida, Alundra Blaze.
Having competed against countless competitors the world over, I can assure you, Alundra Blaze is no stranger to squaring off against the very best of the best.
And that's exactly what Alundra Blaze has in front of her here tonight with Paige, the best. In fact, last year at the tender age of 21, Paige became the youngest competitor to ever win the Divas Championship.
All right, let's do this. I'm gonna fuck you up, Paige. I think I'm Alundra Blaze, but I could be completely wrong. Yeah, I'm Alundra Blaze.
This California crowd is on its feet.
Totally forgot
you.
Get off me, bitch. Get off me.
Of generations, Paige, one of today's most dominant divas, taking on the Hall of Famer, Alundra Blaze.
Yeah, and if some of you younger fans out there have yet to see Alundra Blaze in action, I assure you, you're in for a treat. She is absolutely among the best of all time.
Alundra's reputation certainly precedes her king.
Paige is beating my ass right now.
More than a decorated resume to get past Paige here tonight. I can assure you and everyone that.
About to get a couple headshots soon. Yeah.
Well, that's
one drop kick. A one draw.
Oh,
I like Medusa. And
look at that reversal. She reversed it. Elbow connection.
I gotta say, is Medusa for how old she is? Boy, at the Hall of Fame, she was still quite a beauty.
Oh, out of nowhere.
Bringing it back between the ropes.
Working on that leg. Good old WWE storytelling right there, let me tell you. I don't know what her finish is. Oh yeah, look at that. By the hair.
Oh, did she take a shot there?
Wow.
Oh no.
Oh boy.
What a painful mistake.
I think I saw
fuck you.
She's
kicking my butt. All right, Paige. You don't want me to get back up. I'm gonna have to take you to school. Honestly, when I get back up, I'm gonna take you to school. Jeez, she is whooping my ass.
Oops.
It's on now, bitch.
Oof. Not your garden variety impact on that one. Not the most effective striking here. What an amazing counter that was. She reversed it. Oh, that body is taking some serious damage. The balance of powers shifted.
That's a very long taunt. That's a very wrong suit. What the fuck are
that
you doing?
One went wide.
Oh my gosh, Paige, you are whooping my booty.
Inside the ring now.
My booty hole.
Oh no, she's in a bad way now.
She might win.
Hey, she's not going away yet.
Just kidding.
Oh, nice high impact.
I really suck at this game, don't I?
The tide definitely seems to be changing.
Man, she's making it look easy here. And she drops like a sack of potatoes.
idea. Ow.
She won't do much damage with attacks like that one. That back was clearly part of her game plan heading in.
Apparently it says just hold L up and push her. I don't think that's true. And
the fight must go on.
Fuck off, you bitch. Try to pin me again. I'll freak you up.
The carnage. The impact. Just debilitating.
I may lose this. I'm really upset.
She's on an absolute tear right now. The counter. Oh,
that's what nice you counter. Get. Oh my gosh.
She reversed it. The shoulders are in, the shoulders up. Adding insult to potential injury here. This is a painful submission hold. And used to great effect here. This is such a painful hold. There's the escape. She reversed.
You have to be kidding me, man.
That was a heavy shot.
What the f- Well, this is interesting. She's gonna beat the hell out of me. Oh, yeah.
The velocity, the impact. You could hear it. Good escape. She looks, and there's the kick out. She reversed it.
Oh my God.
The camel clutch being applied. There's the escape. She strikes just as hard as any other diva on the roster. Maybe harder. This might be big. Looking,
I don't know what that is, but that's pretty cool. I just like... Okay, perform airplane. Up and hold X in front of standing opponent. There we go. Fuck, took me long enough, right?
Longtime WWE fans will never forget the Smash Mouth series of matches that Alundra Blayze had.
What the hell is her moves again?
With the legendary Bull Nakano in the early 90s.
You're right about that, JR.
I was ringside for their historic encounter at SummerSlam 1994, and I can honestly say that their battles may very well have changed the women's wrestling scene forever.
Of course, that night, Alundra Blayze retained her women's championship, but she wasn't so lucky a few months later when Nakano dethroned the champ in a thrilling match from Japan.
Just getting really pissed off at this match, actually. It took me so long to do.
Great crab locked in. Good base. This is going to be difficult to fight out of. There's no escaping this. Ah! I have a feeling. Here's the cover.
Oops. I'm a fucking retard. Excuse my language, actually. It's very rude of me.
Wait a minute. She's going for it again. She's got the cover.
Finally.
Alundra Blayze with a win. Is this enough?
Jeez, that took too long for me.
Blayze has defeated Paige.
Well, that's how you prove.
But yeah,
here is your winner.
I'm going to leave this as part one, and I'm going to do part two with the other matches next. Hopefully we don't have another issue where it just took me like 3 minutes to do one stupid move. But yeah, thanks for watching. See you in part two.
...lessons here tonight that she will undoubtedly educate the entire crop of divas on in the very near future.
All right, guys, see you in part two.